Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to another build challenge. So today's build challenge, as you can see, is based around weird shapes, and I have seen other simmers do this challenge before, but I will be doing a very interesting twist with this particular challenge. So all in all, we are currently in the world of Oasis Springs, and I'm going to try and construct an entire home out of some very funky shapes that maybe you may not have heard of before. So looking at the shapes themselves, we have a parallelogram, we have a trapezoid, we have a pie, a stadium, a chevron, and something called a quatrefoil, which is pretty interesting. And for our six different rooms, we will have the kitchen, dining room, living room, bedroom, bathroom, and the study. So those are all the rooms and all the possible shapes that they could be in. And I'm going to do this a little bit old-fashioned. If you guys have seen these challenges before, you know the drill. I pretty much use my laptop case kind of like drawing names out of a hat. So I will put all the rooms in, I'll put all the shapes in, and this will be totally random. All right, guys, so starting off this challenge today, we will get started on the very first room, and the very first room shall be... we have the living room. All right, you guys, there it is in the camera. If you can see it, we have the living room. And for our very first weird, funky shape, we will officially have... all right, we have the parallelogram. There it is, you guys, if you can see it in the camera. That is the shape of our very first room. So this challenge is going to be a little bit tricky, you guys, because I don't really know how the rooms are going to fit together. But I do want to go for more of a mid-century sort of retro look for this. So I'm kind of trying to fit into the world of Oasis Springs, and we'll pretty much see where this takes us. All right, so parallelogram. A parallelogram is a quadrilateral, and it has two sets of parallel sides. So it's sort of like this figure. So we do have two parallel sides here, and then we do have two parallel sides kind of going on a diagonal. So this is about what it looks like. All right, mid-century. I'm thinking we can do probably a mix of stone and wood. So I think that's the direction I want to go. Okay, I think I like this sandy rock. I think I like this type of vibe. Thinking I'll do some wood paneling on the other rooms, but for now, I think this is a pretty good base. So going in, let's see what we have. I think we can just do probably a solid wood flooring. I like to keep it simple. I like to keep it simple with the flooring just so everything feels a little bit more homogeneous. For windows, all right, let's see what we have. We do want to keep it very modern. I do like these windows from Spade as well, so these are really cool options. Ooh, could do something big like this. We're going to have a nice giant view. And then I'll go in and grab a door to complete this area. This is actually not that bad. I do like this option from Tiny Living, and I don't think I ever use it, but I do think it works here. It's very geometric. I think it fits with the mid-century look. Okay, so if this is our living room, I'm thinking we're gonna have to connect the rooms somewhere on the right side. So this is gonna be a little wonky, but we're gonna roll with it. Start with a good old fireplace. So something a little bit more modern. I'm thinking this one from the Get Together pack. Probably go in for a nice flat screen TV. So I'll do probably this one. This one's not bad. Also the one from City Living. It's gonna be a little hard watching TV on this. I'm not gonna lie, you guys. Maybe I'll scoochie over here. So we have more room for some sofas, some armchairs perhaps. I think overall I would like for this place to be probably a little bit more on the minimalistic side. So probably something like this. I think this works fine. That's not too bad. Do we have any better options for lamps? Ooh, yes. Tiny Living to the rescue. Yes, yes, yes. So we can do this one. Color scheme. Color scheme, I haven't really worked out. I think I would like this to be a little bit more colorful. So I think we'll use more of Tiny Living, maybe some City Living in the mix. Rugs, rugs, rugs. Where are the good options? Let's see. We could do, we could do like a shaggy rug. I think that's very indicative of the era, if I do say so myself, so that's not a bad option. Let's go simple on the rug with a little bit of shag. I'm thinking we can also do more Tiny Living, and potentially we may be able to do some City Living as well. So I'll put this here. I do also like the pseudo beanbag that comes with this pack. I think it's gonna fit the look just right, so maybe something like this. Ooh, maybe these chairs. I do like these. More viewing spots for the movie. I think that's great. So I can situate these here. I can kind of match these colors with the purple, kind of that muted lavender, maybe, maybe, maybe you guys, I think this could work. little bit more clearance. This diagonal is funky, you guys. How do I make a proper viewing angle here? I think that's the question. This lamp is so strange, guys. I always think this looks like a UFO. I kind of get like weird War of the Worlds kind of feel with this thing. Like there are tentacles coming down. Maybe it fits, but I'm just not really feeling it, you guys. So maybe not this one. I think instead we'll go with this. Kind of go with a more contemporary lamp, also from the Tiny Living Pack. Maybe some lamps. Can we get some kind of wall sconce, perhaps? Something a little bit more modern? So spot A does have some good options. I do like this option. It's a little bit more narrow and sleek, but I do love this really warm square light as well. But I think for today's look, we're gonna go for the skinny, thin option also from spot A. So I think these will work fine. Plants to the rescue, you guys. So let's see something tall and thin. That actually doesn't work too badly. I also like this base game option. So I think we can go with this. I'm gonna scale it down just a little bit. All right, so the entrance for the other room is probably going to be on this wall. So I'm not really sure what I'm going to do with it, but I do wanna leave enough space there. What I will do though, is I will create a little bit of a sort of hallway moment here because we do need a place to take off our shoes. This mat is not working, you guys. it's a very awkward fit. So maybe I'll do without it. So I'll do this. Let's see. Maybe a hat along the wall, perhaps? Something like this. All right, I do think we need a really nice ceiling light here. Just a nice way to create an entrance space. Thinking we could do possibly tiny living again with just a nice little cluster of objects like this. We could also use the Seasons lamps, which are really fun. They're pretty ginormous, if I say so myself, but we can have some really interesting swatches. So we do have a little bit of pink. I think this could do, yeah, it's a little funky, but I think we can make it work. I do wanna add a full length mirror in, probably next to the door. So if you wanna look good before you leave the house, that is definitely the way to do so. I actually don't mind this slate gray, so I think we'll go with that. And I do also want to add in some curtains because, yeah, this family would have everything on display. If they're watching some really awesome show, all of the neighborhood's going to watch it with them. So let's give them a little bit of privacy. And I'm thinking we can do that with a little bit of Desert Luxe, perhaps. All right, the room is a little tiny bit barren. So I think what I'll do is I will find a bookcase. Not sure which one just yet, but definitely something to fit the look. Okay, so maybe this bookcase thing is not going to work out. I'm trying to find better options to suit the style. I think this option is not too bad. I think it fits enough. And I think I will also have some clutter on the fireplace as well. Books are always welcome. Yes, giant books though. We really need to fill up the space. So I think I'll do that one there. And then maybe this one right here. All right, so I think I'm pretty happy with our parallelogram living room. And like I said, I'm gonna leave this a little bit empty on this side because I really have to figure out how this house fits together. All right, guys, so the next room we are working on is officially going to be the study room. All right, there it is, you guys. If you can see in the camera, our next room is the study area. And then for our really funky shape, we will officially have we have the quatrefoil. All right, there it is, you guys. If you can see in the camera, we have the quatrefoil. And, oh gosh. This shape, you guys, is quite wild. If you haven't heard of a quatrefoil before, I'm going to try and create it here in The Sims. I'm going to use some curved walls, which I know they are an abomination. They do not work correctly, but I'm going to try my best. I'm going to try my best to hopefully connect this space. All right, so the quatrefoil. Quatrefoil is pretty much a square that has four semicircles attached to it. So it's something like this. I'm gonna go in and add the little curved rooms here. I think I can scoochie these like this. All right, we have a heart. Not quite yet. This is a funky, weird shape challenge. So we're not quite there yet, but here we are just completing the look like this. Okay, so that is our shape. I have no idea how we're going to connect it to the first one. But yeah, here we go. Here we go, you guys. All right. Now, if I'm doing the study area, I'm thinking I could go probably like this. I can cut into the house a little tiny bit, but it just doesn't make sense. We could do this. It kind of situates along the wall, but I just don't see how this is going to fit very well. So I think we're going to have a weird courtyard moment. So yeah, this is going to be hard, but here we are. Okay, so let's do some more stone. I think I would also like some other kind of pattern, maybe this wood pattern. I think we can kind of mimic the way wood was used back then. I did notice that there was a lot of wood paneling, especially in homes from the 70s, if I'm not mistaken. So could do this. Gonna try and put a light probably in every one of these corners, as weird as that may be. So something like this. Perfect. Okay, this is a huge, huge study. I don't even know if these windows are gonna work. Okay, that works pretty well. It kind of clips a little bit at the top, but forgive me, you guys. This is a weird room. This house is probably going to look like it's from outer space, like it just landed from Mars. But you know what? It works. I think it fits the vibe. Nope. These doors just don't want to cooperate. I cannot flip them around, but okay. Gonna roll with it. Okay. Could even do some kind of sunken in sort of living room, even though it's not a living room. Forgive me. Just gonna cheat and use this little fence feature. Just like that, pop it down. Perfect. So we do have this. Let's see what we have. So I think the first one can be probably an artist station here because, you know, guys, that's just my go-to. I'm overwhelmed. There are several spaces to fill. Where is the painter's set? Oh, we do have these. I do enjoy this kind of cluttering some paintings along the wall like so. Probably some kind of mat for the paint. If something looks good, probably something maybe even simple like this. That's not too bad. And I think I want to complete this space with perhaps a better light. I often use this one if I do an artist station, so this could work. Can we cooperate? Kind of does. It's glitching. These curved walls are a nightmare, you guys. They glitch. But it's not too bad. I don't think it's too bad. I'll try to leave some of them, but they're kind of spazzing out on me, so I think that's gonna have to do. I think the next area will probably be, let's do a knitting nook. I think that could be kind of fun. This option once more, probably put it like this. Is it embroidery? Is it sewing? I can never remember these things, but here they are. Perfect. We'll use this here. And I do want to give this area probably some kind of woven rug just to fit with the theme a little bit more. So I think we can pull from the, where are you? Yes, tiny living pack, just like this. And I probably will also grab the lighting once more. So I think I'll use this one here, just like that. I feel like we don't have a ceiling. We don't have a ceiling. Oops. Yes, absolutely. That's better. Okay, I was wondering why the lighting was so weird in here, but I think this works fine. This one I can probably do just a standard desk. So let me get that. Yeah, I think this one could work. It's still a little futuristic. I'm getting, you know, Meet the Jetsons vibes, Meet the Robinsons, the Jetsons. I'm getting them so confused. That kind of mid-century futuristic vibe, if that makes sense. So I think this could work. The wood tones don't match, unfortunately, but I think that will do. I think it's close enough. If not, I'm gonna have to change the desk. The desk may have to go. Okay, gonna bring in the curtains once more. Just kind of going around, and these windows are glitching again, you guys. I don't know what to do about it, but I think it's gonna have to do. I do like this kind of hanging plant from the paranormal pack, so I think I'll use this. Could I put in some plants? I do like these plants as well. I think we may need it somewhere in here. Why? Why, Sims 4? Why do you not have matching wood tones? Why? But yeah. Okay. I'm not going to be like the fairies in Sleeping Beauty. I'm just going to stick with this color because I think at the end of the day, the wood tones are just not going to match, unfortunately. But we can live with it. We can live with it. I did also like the idea of some kind of little file cabinet. I think that could be really fun. Ah, here they are. Kind of like that look. If this is like someone's office space, I think this could be fairly appropriate. And I think the end table will probably serve as a little, maybe something to hold drinks, some candles, something like that perhaps. And I'm thinking we can use one of these really nice cushy pseudo bean bags once more. So I'll put one here. Okay, and here you are. Perfect. Yeah, I like this. It's a cozy little desk moment. Could do this, kind of have some smaller paintings here, like this. Probably do these. These are fun. Come with me. Don't fall through the floor. Sims are going to have no idea how to access you. I think it's coming. It's kind of difficult. I'm not going to lie to you guys. The internal space, the main area on the inside, is very tricky. Could I do different couches? I can do probably something like this even. Could also go base game. Could base game be the trick? We do have this really futuristic looking couch. These are fun. These are actually fun. They're a little bit more contemporary, but I don't really mind them too much. And they do mirror the lights above, which is really cool. So I think this could do the trick. Yeah, it's a little bit Wes Anderson, if you guys know what I mean. I think I am remembering the correct director, if I'm not mistaken. But you know what? I do like this vibe. We got a lot of stuff going on here. So I think this is really fun, and I think we're ready to go on to the next room. All right, guys. So the next room is officially going to be the bedroom. All right, you guys. So there it is. If you can see it in the camera, we do have the bedroom. And for the official funky shape, the trapezoid. All right, you guys, there it is. The trapezoid, if you can see it in the camera, that is going to be our weird shape. All right, so for the trapezoid is actually not too weird of a shape. It is kind of similar to the parallelogram, but I believe the trapezoid only has one pair of parallel sides. So it is a quadrilateral. It does have four sides, and I'm going to try and branch off of this living room space. Something like this, and then I'm going to kind of close it off like that, and we officially have our trapezoid. Yeah, really fun shape so far. But I'm going to pull more of these spa day windows and just give a really nice big view. Gonna leave this space open as well because I don't really know what's gonna happen there. So I'll do this. This is a pretty decent base, I think. I think it's gonna work. I do wanna pull in this rug once more. I'm gonna make my life a little bit easier. For the bed, definitely want something more modern. I do like this kind of moment here, which is not too bad. I actually really enjoy this swatch. It kind of has this really nice slate blue kind of tone to it. It does have some nice geometric kind of stripe accents. I do want to use some kind of statement piece on the wall because there is a lot of real estate to cover. So let's see what we have here. Yeah, I do like this cityscape a lot. I think we can go for a little bit of a cooler, tranquil vibe. All right, maybe these can work. Maybe these little ones can work this time. So I'm gonna take these out. Gonna do a little swapperoo here. Situate these back over here like this. The dresser is pretty small, but I will add probably a little sitting area here. Maybe this is an area to get ready. You know, putting on your favorite attire, if you will. Definitely need a full mirror here. So I'll go in like this, add in a tall mirror somewhere. Ooh, this is kind of a fun moment. Kind of peeking behind the shoes, just a little tiny bit. I do want to match more of the blue in this room, so I'll go like this. I think we can even squeeze in a TV, so let me do that. I'm going to put in a little tiny accent table underneath, and then I will go back in and use that fabulously curved and large TV. Yes, scale it down like so. I do also want to pull in more paintings because we just don't really have a lot of that going on. So I'll borrow these once more and probably put them maybe over here. Do they work? They actually do. They actually do work quite a bit. I feel like I'm not enjoying this mirror anymore. Maybe just neutral. Yeah, neutral. It's more of a slate gray now, so it does match with the bed a little bit. Then we do have another area here, which I'm honestly not too sure what to do with. So I think what I'll do is just make probably a reading nook again. Not really sure, you guys. Probably not going to be accessible, but we're going to pretend. Have a little futon, a little ottoman here to put your legs up and chill out. Let me see if I can actually pull in some more art. I did like the base game paintings here, and I think I'll use this swatch once more because it does fit. I do enjoy how that looks. All right, just like the good old days when we had magazines. I don't know about you guys, but I used to read a lot of magazines when I was a kid. I used to get Reader's Digest from my grandpa, which surprisingly I did enjoy as a child. And funny enough, I read a lot of tabloids. My mom loves celebrities, so she used to have a lot of magazines about celebrity scandals and who wore it best and all that fun stuff. You know, some kind of bathroom read is better than nothing. So here we are, a little bit of nostalgia. All right, I think we're pretty much good to go with our trapezoid bedroom, which did fit perfectly with the parallelogram. But again, we have to go to the next room and hopefully it all fits together well. Okay, so the next room we have is officially going to be the dining room. All right, there it is, you guys. Dining room, there it is in the camera there. And for the next crazy shape, we will officially have, we have a stadium. All right, there it is, you guys, the stadium shape. And I actually didn't know that this was considered a true geometric shape, but this shape is not too complicated, but it is a little bit weird to fit into the build. And essentially it is a rectangle shape. It is shaped like this. And we do have two semicircles on the side, so something like this. Gonna go ahead and pop these in like so. All right, and there we go. That is pretty much our stadium shape. Now, I think the hard part is, again, it's just not really going to fit natively into this build. Yeah, this is huge. How do I make this shorter? What do I do? It's not working. I just wish I could put it on an angle, if you guys know what I mean. If I could fit this in diagonally, this would have been great. But again, we're kind of stuck in really weird predicaments. This is going to be one really weird dining room, you guys, because if I'm connecting off the sides of this, unfortunately, I can't really do lots of windows here. So yeah, the view is going to be kind of sad, if I'm being honest with you guys. Can I remember what shapes are left? Yeah, I do kind of remember what shapes are left. So maybe I can scoochie over like this. Scoochie, scoochie. Okay, so there's this. I'd still do a door, but the door is going to have to be an angle, which is very weird. And it's cutting in, but I think it's going to have to do. Going to go in and add probably some more windows around the edges, because I think we need as much light as we can get in this little tiny jelly bean of a room. Probably going to bring in the shag rug once more. Nice long glass table like this. Going to bring in some of those funky lights that I really love over here. And maybe one right here. Can I make it bigger? Could actually make it bigger. That could be really fun. Could do these. Kind of weird chairs, if I'm being honest with you guys. They almost look like car seats. Can I use them though? Because I never use them. I think I'll try them out. They're funky, but we're going to roll with it. And for decor, decor is going to be hard because we can probably fit another room here if my planning allows me to. So I think that can be okay. I will try to add in some more plants though, because it is pretty barren. So let me pull some that I used. I do like some of these hanging plants from the tiny living pack. So maybe something like this. Can we make this more symmetric? Maybe a little bit more balanced. Alrighty. Maybe it's a little bit too matchy-matchy, but I think we'll do that. Make life a little easier. I'm gonna bring back this base game plant, which I do love. Ooh, base game. Base game to the rescue. Really like this really kind of palm frond plant, if you will. I think that works great. I know Devon Bumpkin really enjoys using this plant, and I totally agree. It's very versatile. Definitely fits a lot of styles, so I think that's a really nice moment there. And I do want to create a little tiny bit of a centerpiece in the middle, which, honestly, I'm not really sure what I'm going to put here. Probably some kind of small sculpture or something along those lines. Maybe this, if I scale it down. Kind of interesting. And you are here. Here. Perfect. Alrighty. Just a little bit of color in here. And it doesn't hurt to have some fruit available. And I think this pretty much works for our little dining room area. Alright guys, we officially have two rooms left. And our very next room is going to be the bathroom. All right, there it is. Bathroom, you guys, if you can see it there. And for the next really funky shape, we only have two options left, and it will officially be the chevron. All right, there it is, you guys. If you can see it in the camera there, it is the chevron. And this will be interesting because the chevron has kind of two different shapes. There are kind of some variants on how it can be created. But I think what will work great is I can actually put the bathroom on this little corner here and kind of branch off the bedroom, which it's going to ruin the layout of the bedroom a little bit. But I think we can kind of sneak it in there very stealthily. All right, that being said, the chevron kind of has an arrow shape, and I do believe it goes something like this. It comes to a little bit of a point like so, and then it kind of drops down at an angle. So I do believe this is roughly the shape of a chevron. Again, there are some variants. I do know that the chevron logo for the gas station company, that chevron is a little different as well. More or less, it's kind of this triangular form, sort of like an arrowhead, but it does have a little bit of this kind of internal divot, if that makes sense. So that is what we'll do here. And this space is weird. This space is really weird, you guys. What I can actually do is I can almost have the... Yeah, I can actually have the bathroom be part of an entrance. It can have two entrances, potentially from the dining room area and also the bathroom area. So it's a little bit unorthodox. It's a little bit unorthodox, if you will. But I do think we can make it work. Maybe one entrance here for the guests. And then if I do have an entrance on this side, I'm thinking we will have to kind of shimmy everything over probably around here. All right. Okay, cool. We have two entrances now. In terms of windows, I think I will go back and use more of that spot A window here because it's a really cool shape, if I'm being honest with you guys. And how do we want to do this? We can do this in a few different ways. We do have the entrance roughly in that area. Ooh, we could have some counters. Could have some counters along the wall. Ooh, spot A. Spot A with this light blue is actually quite interesting. I do like the look of this. Ooh, I do love this sink from Spot A though. This one is so gorgeous and it kind of works. For the mirrors, I'm thinking we can also go back and do some tiny living because I do think they fit quite well, just like this. And I think for the toilet, I'll go with something. Yeah, let's do tiny living once more. Scoochie scoochies in there. I was thinking we may be able to take this window out as much as I don't want to and probably do a little area here for the shower. Just a little bit of a... Yeah. I cannot cut through. No, I cannot cut through. Why? There goes the plan. There went the plan, you guys. All right. Okay. So I think we can still squeeze by. We may be able to squeeze by with this. But I can squeeze the shower in, probably a standing shower like so. Should be accessible. I unfortunately cannot playtest this at the moment, but I think this will do. And then we can have probably our towels along here. I'll just grab some from the base game. Just like that. Little tiny bits of pastel. Sneaking in that little tiny bit of color there. I think that works fairly well. Okay. Slots are not perfect, but they do work. They do work a little tiny bit. Here we go. Ooh, love this option. Okay, I think I'll just do another staggered mirror effect just to add a little bit of decor with a little bit of edge. So I'll use one here, put one here, and just kind of pop it up a little bit like this. And then another one at the regular standard height. Probably could have aligned better on the wall, but it's still interesting, I hope. Little bits of slate blue, because that is my favorite color for some reason. You need some gorgeous plants because it is quite barren. For some reason, I associate hanging plants with bathrooms. I don't really know why. But we're going to do it. We're going to pull it from the living room over there. Where exactly? Probably here. Close enough to the light. And hopefully it doesn't block your Sims from the toilet area. So probably something like this. Okay, I think that is about it for our chevron bathroom. I'm never really too keen on decorating bathrooms, but I think this is the best layout I could create given the really weird shape that we had to work with. So I think that is about it. And moving on now, we have our final room, which I do believe is the kitchen, if I'm not mistaken. But just to double check, yes, here it is. That is the kitchen there. And for the weird shape, I totally forgot what the last weird shape is. And officially, the weird shape is the pie. All right, there it is, you guys. The pie is the very last shape. And this one is weird. I've seen some sources call it pic, as in P-I-C. But most people refer to it as pie. And it's pretty much a circular room that has one piece taken out. It has one quarter taken out of the build. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop these down like this. We virtually have a Pac-Man room, and this is going to be our kitchen. Can I fit it somewhere? That's not going to look terrible. That's the question. Yeah. I made my life so hard, you guys. I don't know why I chose these really weird shapes. I can actually, strangely enough, fit it in here. I just don't know how this is going to work. I think what I'll do is I'll have it connected to the living room. So very weird layout. It makes no sense. Oh man, we broke into the lovely bedroom, which is sad, but I think it'll slightly remain intact. Yes. Scoochie scoochie this over so we have more clearance into the kitchen area. And I will put another wall sconce right about here just so we have a little bit more light into this little area. Okay, so off the bat, counters are going to be a nightmare. I'm thinking I can actually delete this one here, this window, and then just probably have some counters along the wall. Thinking we can do possibly spot A. I don't really mind these base game options either. The fridge in the corner. Like that. Maybe. It's a very tight squeeze. I don't think Sims can use that. Which is unfortunate because I think that is the best place we can put it. Need the stove. Probably put it about maybe, yeah. I think I'll have to put it, unfortunately, possibly against the fridge itself. But I could also do this and have this one from Parenthood here, which it's not too bad. Kind of go with an orange color scheme here. I think that could also work. It's very fun, very colorful. I could go white on the fridge itself. Let me see if there are better options. Yeah. So cramped. But it kind of fits. We still have that retro vibe going on. The sink. We do need a sink in here, so that's a little bit troublesome. Let me see if I can move this out just a little bit, just to give a little bit more clearance on the sink itself. Fit this in here just for a little bit of fun. Has that same light blue color, and I think we have enough clearance still, so not too shabby, hopefully. Probably squeeze in some aprons on the wall just to complete the look. Okay, I think this is about it. It's really squished, but I think this just does the kitchen sort of justice. This is about the best I could do with the kitchen, and I know it's probably not going to function perfectly, but I think it's the best solution I had with the pie shape itself. All right, guys, so we do have the full house complete. It is super wonky. I'm just going to go in and add some details now. Unfortunately, we do have a little bit of this glitching in the curved wall moment, but I think that's the best I can do with it. But we will go back in and add some nice finishing touches just so this actually looks like a house. All right, can we add some pieces to the top just to make it a little bit more structurally intact? If that makes sense, it's a little bit of a stretch, but I think it can happen. Could we do something a little bit rockier just to give it a little bit of an edge? Because I do think we need to cover the roof with a little bit of something. So I think we can go like this. All right, just gotta close this little tiny bit. If it works, I think it's gonna glitch. Okay, that works. It's not bad. All right, and let's add in a little bit of landscaping. So I think we can pull perhaps some really nice palm trees. I think that kind of fits the look a little bit. Scaling them down just to add a little bit of variety here and there. All right, I think I will also go in and enclose this area the best I can. So I will pick out a nice fence that I think will go. Maybe some hedges. I think hedges are usually a good option. And I think what I'll do is I'll try to enclose this area here. Where? Probably here. Yes, I can do that. Great. That works pretty well. So we have a nice little closed in backyard area like so. Then I would like some very nice debug stepping stones. So these I'll just pull right from base game itself and slowly, ever so slowly rotate them. So they kind of lead into the street area. I will also go in and maybe add in a few of these very interesting mounds. I think they work pretty well for landscaping and they are quite fun to use. Also gonna go in here and have some terrain paint just to complete this little tiny walkway. So I think maybe just some regular gravel may do the trick here. Probably gonna make a little bit of a sort of walkway into the backyard area. So I think that could be really cool. Okay, whoa, that's too big. Scale it down a little bit. Probably gonna finish this area off with a little bit of desert luxe because why not? I think it's just gonna work quite well. And we do have some loungers here which do fit the vibe. So I'll put one here just so we can get an idea of how everything will kind of situate roughly in this house. If you ever did wanna use it or recreate it, don't really know why you would because it's a really weird design, but hopefully it works. Just adding in a little bit of cactus detail here, not going too hardcore, but just a little bit of something just to add a little bit of fun elements to the landscaping itself. So for better or for worse, this is more or less the completed house. I didn't go too crazy with doing the final decorative elements because This is a really weird design, and I don't think anyone is going to want to recreate this. I don't even know if it's totally functional, but I did want to make sure that this did resemble something in Oasis Springs, something mid-century, something that is slightly modern and slightly retro. All right, and that is pretty much a wrap on today's challenge. This was the weird shape Oasis Springs mid-century house build. It's kind of a mouthful. It was kind of wild and kind of janky with how everything fit together. But as always, I hope you guys had fun. I hope this inspires you to do your own challenges. And just like always, please feel free to share your thoughts on how I did. Did I succeed? Did I totally bomb? Did you have a favorite or least favorite room? Definitely let me know in the comments as well. And just like always, this has been TownieSimBuilds signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.